Hello and welcome back to Let's Play Svea Rike 2 with me, Acciyn. When we last left off, I was kicking ass while the rest of the Swedish families were losing province after province. I remember a time where I was pretty much equal in the number of lands I held with the rest of the families, and now we have one family who is exiled to the middle of Norway. These guys have two provinces. These guys are doing pretty good. It's the Tott family, I believe. I don't like them. Well, maybe that's it, because they bought... whatever. It's not looking good for the rest of them, but I'm kicking some serious ass, and that's all that matters. So, we are back in 1636. It's time to advance to the next turn and through the next 5 years, and hopefully something good will happen. Like war. War's always good, right? We are only at war with these guys here. Right, and they are invading me. That's an easy win for me. And... Jesus. Why do they spam cannons, and why are you invading with that? That I can win. That I can win. No problems there. This, however, might be the one I lose if I don't do something about it. Let's see, can we split these forces to... here, 3,000 cavalry, 5,000 infantry, and move them into support. Now, what are the numbers? Much better. Much, much better. Now, that's an even fight. Oh, it's the Stude family, right. They are the ones. You know, I probably I'm going to try and make a peace treaty with these guys, because seriously, the only ones profiting from a war at this point are they. We don't really profit, and they can have Gotland if they want to. Don't really care about it. Although, considering that is an almost even fight, that is going to be a Swedish marginal loss, I'm kind of debating maybe putting in some infantry of my own just to fuck with them. I am going to need some infantry anyway, so why not? 10,000 Swedish infantry from me should do the trick, like so, and that should win us that battle. Now it's time to fight. We're not gonna order us all. That's the first fight. I might lose this. Just letting you know, I'm not here to per se win the territory. I'm here to make sure that my ally wins. While I have myself a bit of coffee. And this is just so that we can keep these Germans on as little bit of a piece of land as possible, which is going to be the one province. They're obviously going to shoot at me, not really dealing too terrible amounts of damage. Their infantry is just about as good as mine. I do have a slight advantage in numbers in these one-on-one fights, and still I lost. What? Oh, random number generator screwing with me. I see how it is. Well, like I said, I'm not really trying to win this fight so much as I'm trying to make sure my ally wins. You're gonna regret that. It's not a good place to be stepping, Leo. Right, so that battle's won. That's not even no. Actually, you can move up in instead. 500 to 300. Worth it. That's a good number for us. There we go. Oh, that's a mistake. Right. There we go, we won on that flank. We have 1,000 fresh men against... Really? They have that many cavalry there? Holy crap. Okay, this might not be going as well as I thought it was. Do we need to take... Oh, that's a good hit from us. Excellent. That's just 60. I'm not gonna mess around with that. Die, those guys are going to move forward, and these guys are in a position to stop them. And I am going to advance. Okay, those are 1,000 guys. I don't want to advance them. These guys are advancing, the rest of you fight. You need to stay. You need to stay. You must go backwards then. 90 guys to 70. There we go. Oh my Jesus. Did not expect them to kill off the entire stack. Motherfuckers. Right. Oh, I feel sorry for the horse. Wow, those guys haven't even been touched. But I can kill the cavalry. Most of it, anyway. Yeah, no win for me today. But I'm putting the hurt on them. Hopefully my ally will be able to pull through. I'm not too hopeful though. This battle should be easy enough for me to put in the bag as a win. So there we go, and you will stay here. Looks easy enough. My cavalry in the wrong spot, but that's not too much of a concern. Because their cavalry is apparently no match for my superior numbers. Excellent. Next battle. maybe if I do something like this, keep my cavalry on the flanks, some infantry, like that maybe. Well, looks doable. Die, cavalry! I know someone in the comments told me I should be aiming at the infantry rather than the cavalry in the comments of one of my videos somewhere. I don't really keep that good of a track on that, do I? Thing is, cavalry does more damage, and the more cavalry of theirs I can kill, the less damage I will take. It's as simple as that. That's my reason for it. It might not be the best way to play this game, but you know what? I'm playing. So, that's how I do it. Oh, more cannons. There, I shot some infantry. Everyone's happy. Oh, you have those guys too. And I should have attacked with you. Oh. Easy enough of a victory. Now 150 artillery. That's gonna be a pain. Oh, that's gonna be a pain. My cavalry is going to be decimated. But so is theirs. Damn it. Are you shitting me? There we go. That's a cannon shot. Not taking 180 dudes. 1100 dudes on the other hand. Now that's a cannon shot. And as soon as we can get into combat, we should be alright. Once the AI is finished decimating my reinforcements. Yeah. I'm not moving. You're gonna have to come to me. I'm not giving you the first strike. Not after that fucking artillery barrage. Can artillery barrage you? How many did I kill? Good. There we go. That's an entire flank for me. Excellent. This should be a flank for me too, almost. Almost got him. I don't think they're going to attack my cavalry here. Pretty sure they will recognize my superiority. And run. Are you kidding? 100-something guys? You couldn't kill 100-something guys? Killed all the others. They're gonna feel left out now. And surrounded, for that matter. And shot to pieces. Don't forget, shot to pieces. Okay. Not as many losses as I thought I'd get, which is good. And most of them were infantry, so I don't care. Next battle. More cavalry. Right. They seem to want their cavalry out there, so I'm gonna do that. That flank is going to be a bit more protected, which means I'm gonna want some extra dudes over there, and you go over here. Oh, they started all the way over there. How very unsportsmanlike of them. Are you shitting me? There you go. Killing cavalry is what artillery does best. Which is why I hate it when the AI spams artillery. If you hadn't noticed by now, with some of the armies that the enemy AI has been fielding, the AI loves to spam artillery in this game. nothing wrong with that. It's a perfectly valid strategy. It's just annoying and painful. Fortunately, they seem to be a little bit slow in upgrading their cannons. So that gives me somewhat of an advantage in that respect. Also, they like to give me the first strike whenever we go into melee combat, or as melee as you can call, fighting with muskets and crossbows and shooting infantry in the face and killing. Like so. Advance, brave Swedish troops! Kill the Germans in the name of the Swedish Empire! Wow, he actually attacked! Oh, okay. You can retreat! You can attack. You can finish the job. There we go. And he walks right into my trap of cannons! Excellent. Now, what do we have here? Fort Christina, founded in Delaware. Oh! I had to take a drink of water there. This might be interesting. A Swedish colony in the US in 1638. The great power of Sweden must compete with the other great nations in acquiring colonies in the New World. Two ships were sent to the Americas and arrived at Delaware in 1638. The ships were called Kalmarinickel and Fogelgrip. They built a fortress there called Fort Christina. The colony is of course called New Sweden, but is plagued by various plagues, not actual plagues, but you know what I'm talking about. I'm trying to translate this as best as I can. Dutch colonists want the same territory. Rescue ships and new colonists from Sweden are unable to arrive, and in 1655 New Sweden is conquered by the Dutch. What a shame! North America could have been Swedish! Yeah, right. This is kind of an odd choice considering the flavor text here, but we are asked to invest some money in the colonies in the New World. And if it's successful, hint hint, the flavor text says it's not, we get a share in the profit. Well, why not? I have silver to spend. Let's spend 500 silver on that. And an endeavor we know is doomed. Okay, a person who we are able to hire. Rutger von Aschberg. Born in Kurland and fights from horseback on the Swedish side in the 30-year war under General Spanier and Torstensson. During the reign of King Carl Gustav X, he advances to the rank of colonel and participates in the march over Belt, wherever that is. Mm-hmm. after school on that has become Swedish, they start a campaign to make it, you know, Swedish, for the population to be Swedish. The import of Danish books are forbidden, and the priests are forced to preach in Swedish. Every child has to learn the... I have no idea what that book is, if it even exists in English. Luther's can hardly even pronounce it. Anyway, I guess it's some sort of Bible or religious text, and they have to learn it in Swedish. Whoa, text, where did you go? Okay. Oh, I see. I see. So, during this campaign to make Skåne Swedish, since it's been Danish most of the time and up until now, this guy was actually a big part of that campaign, and as a reward, since it was a relatively easy campaign, there were some resistance, but nothing major. This guy was made the Governor General of Skåne, and he managed it in a, for considering the time period, an unusual way by being rather kind and diplomatic about it. He also donated several farms to Lund's university to safeguard its economy, and he is made count in 1687. Oh, good on you, dude. If we were to hire him, our cavalry would get a +1 to defense, and we would get an additional 1,000 cavalry. I might want him. Here is another one. The same deal with his perks, except he gives infantry instead of cavalry. Not so interested, but let's read a little bit about him. Another military person in Sweden during the 17th century. He was also fighting under the generals Benir and Torstensson in the 30-year war, and is the king's right-hand man, Carl the Gustav the X, during the Polish campaign. One of many Polish campaigns Sweden has had during the years. After the peace in Roskilde in 1658, Gustav Otto Stenbock becomes the first Governor General of Skåne, where he defends the peasants' rights against the nobility. I see. So this guy was the Governor General of Skåne until that guy we just read about. Unfortunately for this guy, he was part of Carl the 11th's... Oh, what's the word? Oh, God damn it. Well, basically, Carl the 11th came to the throne as a minor, so he had a bunch of people surrounding him, doing the job of a king until he matured. He was the admiral, basically he was the commander in chief of the navy, so to speak. And It was something that he had neither the money nor knowledge to do. It was a position that didn't suit him at all. So when the king matures, he is dismissed. And I would imagine that's how he lost Skåne. However, he is reinstated as the chief of the admiralty, I guess it would be called, of the fleet, navy, whatever. But he is forced to pay a handsome fine of 210,000 riksdaler, which, as I believe I've covered in a previous video, is a lot of money. A lot of money. And I don't want to hire him. Just so you know. Oh, this is a guy that will let us build, like, nobleman's housing, I believe. Without having a manor beforehand, so we don't have to upgrade it, we can just go straight to nobleman's housing, and if we keep him in our service until he retires, we gain 3 renown points, which, in this game, don't really matter. At least not in this particular save I'm playing right now. Jean de la Vallée, an architect, son of Simon de la Vallée. Studied in France and Italy, well, with a name like that, and is hired as the royal architect when he returns to Sweden. Oh, he apparently designed the first settery roof, whatever that is. If it's even translated that way. I'm not an architect, I have no idea what that is. But apparently it became a very popular style of making roofs. I suppose they looked something like that. And it can be seen even today in the Knight's House in Stockholm. Built the churches Katarina and Hedvig Eleonora in Sweden. Those are both girls' names, because Swedish people like to name their churches after girls for some reason. Oh, he renovated 4 castles and was also hired quite frequently by the De la Gardie family for renovation purposes. And he made a lot of work in renovating Stockholm as a whole. Anyway. Yes, yes, the Germans declared war and I have beaten them back. They didn't take Gotland. I sent 10,000 troops to distract some of the army, and they didn't even take. I really shouldn't be helping my allies. That's something I need to learn. I should not be helping my allies. Other stuff has happened. Oh, hello! It appears I have a shot at winning this game anyway, because the game has apparently decided to award my stupid decision to help my ally with 1 million renown points. No, 10 million. Well, I'm currently one of the most renowned people in the known universe, along with everyone else in Sweden. I'm fine with that. Not gonna do a thing to alter the game in any way, but there you go. I'm now equally renowned to everyone else. Right, okay. Here's a smithy. We need to upgrade as much of this stuff as possible. I can only upgrade them once per turn, that's fine. Or, oh, I need to upgrade that to that in order to make that, and to make that I need 20 more iron. Gotcha, game. I gotcha. Okay, here's a barracks. Don't really need to do anything. Right, I need to kind of, sort of, a little bit upgrade my Eichmann. And I need a university for that. Can I build a university? Embassy? University. What are you talking about, game? I can't. No, I have a university. Right, I have a university. Okay, good. So I will be able to upgrade that next turn, if I remember, which I probably won't. You can scream at me in the comments for that. I will kindly ignore you if you scream. As for the rest of this stuff... Right, I need to do stuff in here. Look at those ridiculous numbers. It's ridiculous. There's nothing else. I can't purchase anything. I can, however... Where are the... Yeah, you are the guy I really don't need. That's for sure. Okay, game, don't scroll too fast. Gustav Horn, is this the guy? No, but my cavalry and artillery would profit from having him. So if I offer him 200 silver, perhaps... Jacob de la Gardi, no, that's not him. Ridovacius, you want shit. Oh, come on, game. Von Steenbock, this is the guy, right? No, that's the infantry guy. I don't want the infantry guy, I want the cavalry. Achberg, there's the guy, yes, cavalry. I'll offer you 350 silver. Please come work for me, and if you don't, I will kill you. Right, there was one more game. Am I not allowed back in? I'm not allowed back in. God damn it! I'm gonna have to fight the Germans again. Okay. Game, if that's how you want it, I will fight the Germans again. Fine. Oh no, you don't. Hello, cavalry. Infantry, I mean. That's probably the remnants from there. They have reinforced that. Right. Now we're at war with Denmark. And they think they can go and take... Oh, you are... No. Just no, Denmark. It's not gonna happen that way. I'm sorry, but you're not taking that from me. It's too valuable, and I have people defending it. Oh, but I'm going to need some reinforcements. Not there. Probably not down here either, actually. And not over here, so I'm going to need reinforcements to beat back the Danish. So if I move you over here, purchase one thing of artillery, two things of cavalry, and eight things of infantry. Move them over here. That's 12,000, 5,800 roughly, and 10. That should be enough to beat the Danish back, and move you back here. You will easily be able to repel that. Okay, quick look, make sure I didn't miss anything, make sure I will be able to beat all of these guys back to where they came from. And diplomacy is going to be a bitch next turn, but I'm gonna have to try it. Right, first battle. Let's fight. I'm ready for ya. I have my one cannon. And my bunch of infantry. Because infantry is the least expensive. Oh god. They've upgraded their cannons. I outnumber them 2-1. I should be able to win this. Their cannons should also be targeting my infantry. Which might not be such a good thing. Please, they're not focus firing. And especially, at least they're not focus firing on my cavalry. If they ever learned how to do that, I'd be kind of screwed. Okay, one more step. I know you can do it. And then we go into fisticuffs. My troops are still the higher ranked ones. I've upgraded mine the most, so I should be able to do this. That's easy enough. That's 1,500 men. That should be good. Move you up here. They're not going to want to attack you, especially not once I've weakened them. Well, at least that's what I'm banking on. They could prove me wrong. And then I'm gonna sob. Gonna keep this little checkered pattern that we got going here. Kill off that. Kill off that. Hopefully that. Yes. And that. And that. Now what are we looking at here? We're looking at a need for reinforcements. There we go. Ow. That was painful. That was really painful. Right. Screw you. They are starting to hurt. Yeah, nope. Not attacking. I'm shooting you down. I lost half my army. Jesus. Oh, this should be easy. Okay. Just form a line. Don't let anyone through. And we should be you're kidding. Fine, if that's how you want to play it. I'm just gonna move over here. Surrender! I outnumber you 3-1 with superior forces. What are you hoping to accomplish by this? I'm even gonna give you the first attack. Yeah, you're not even taking it! Fine. I'll attack you. You're down to 200 men! There's nothing you can do. I've boxed you in, even. You're not even moving anymore. You've given up. Why not hit the surrender button? I have one, I assume you do too. It's the one with the white flag and the flames. It's not that hard to miss. Or spot, whatever. Jesus. Can you tell that I haven't had enough coffee today? Because I kind of haven't had enough coffee today. Hope that guy had enough coffee today, because most of them are dead. Well, not most of them. Most of them are about to be dead. That's for sure. As we valiantly and slowly charge our army forward. Don't shoot until you see the white pixel representing their eye! Oh good, you saw it. You know, I could have stayed back and just shot at them, considering they don't have cannons and I do, but oh well. That would have taken too long. That's my excuse. And they've decided not to even attack me anymore. That's Swedish. Right. They have the... Oh, I almost misclicked there. I wanted to kill the cavalry. Not just because it was cavalry this time, because they actually had the most men in their unit. And also because they were cavalry. And this should be the final fight, and this should be the most even one. Oh god, I might actually lose this. Well, no, we're going up against the Germans. They don't have the same shooting a big ball of iron technology that the Danish do. So we should be fine. I really wish I could target their artillery. There we go. First blood to me. I really need to grab some more iron and start producing more artillery. I wasn't done moving, game, but thank you for taking away my turn. Always appreciate it when that happens. Probably just clicked right on him, and the game thinks that that means that I'm done with my turn, whatever. I'm still winning this. I'm determined. I have done so before, and I can do it again, and this... Oh. I just noticed they've actually upgraded their cannons. Well, fucking hell. Mine are still bigger, though. Ho 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 ho, you think you're surviving? No. None of you are. We're gonna need someone over here. I think that's almost everyone except for you. Yeah, that's right. Walk directly in front of my people so that they can murder you. That's the best strategy ever. Let the enemy murder you. That's how everyone wins a battle. Apparently we have one more! Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. So are you bored watching this series yet? I'm kind of bored playing it, to be perfectly honest. I'm trying my best to get myself to play it so it's done and I can move on to other things. And really, I shouldn't be complaining. Because it is a pretty good game. The only really bad part about it is this combat system, which... It's not really bad, it just takes forever. Because they can only move one hex square move point thing at a time. And you can't group move them. And sure, it's an old game, it's to be expected. It's just tedious being used to games that go faster than this in my spoiled modern age. Com- complaining. I'm done with that. I've vented. I'm all good. Let's just kill these guys and try to negotiate a peace treaty next turn. Make sure I remember to do that. Not do some changes and then exit out of the screen so that I'm not allowed to. That would be bad. And that would be death. I sent it your way and you received it admirably. All three of them. Holy crap, those were good shots. I say that and then my cavalry decides to be a complete fuck up. Well, no, actually, they're going up against almost even numbers. See, they could do it, though. What's wrong with you guys? Okay, box them in and then we're done. Just do a little bit of a flanking maneuver and there we go. Oh, we're done. Ordinare mail. Actually, this is the name of a newspaper, so I'm going to say it as I think it's pronounced because this is pretty old Swedish. Ordinare post tidener. Tidender. Even. Whatever. In the beginning of 1643. The postmaster in Stockholm starts giving out a newspaper with that name. With news! Oh, that's interesting. It is later merged with the paper with that name, Inrikes Tidningar. Inrikes Tidningar, national newspapers, basically, is what that translates into. I'm not going to try translating that because it's old Swedish and I don't feel like it. But it's still being printed and delivered to this day with under the name Post och Inrikes Tidningar, mail and national newspapers. And apparently it's Europe's oldest newspaper. The game wants me to support this by donating 500 silver. Which I suppose is something that will give me renown, and since I actually have many millions of renown now, I might as well, because why not? So I might actually get enough renown. Not likely though, but you know. The peace in Bremsebro. I will read this as soon as I've taken myself a bit of water. Ooh, and this is interesting, and it's... Oh, this is funny. This is funny. Okay, I'm gonna... Jesus, I thought that was the end of it, but no. Well, Sweden entered into an alliance with France in 1652. Bonaire has victory over the German army in Germany in 1638-39, and a truce at Brandenburg in 1641. Sweden once again focuses on its arch enemy Denmark. In December of 1643, Lennart Torstensson goes on a blitzkrieg assault of northern Germany, defeats the Danish cavalry at Kolding, and takes possession of Jylland. At the same time, the Swedish army marches into Jämtland and Härjedalen, which I can show you on the map if I remember. I'm probably not going to. Right, apparently the Dutch are pretty pissed off at Denmark as well for a toll they've been imposing for for moving their ships into the... God damn it! I've had a comment telling me whatever the body of water in between Sweden and Finland. Whatever, you know what it is. I don't have to know what it's called. But the Dutch send their navy to kick the shit out of the Danish navy. Denmark is defeated, and Sweden prepares to invade. The French, being pansies that they are, interfere right around this point, and they want peace in the north because they want to be buddies and best friends with both Sweden and Denmark because they're French. Sweden not wanting to offend the French too much because the French might start crying. Sign a peace treaty in Bremsebro where Härjedalen, Jämtland, Gotland and Ösel become Swedish, and Halland becomes Swedish 30 years later. Now, game wise, what this does, which is kind of funny because of how the map was looking, Jämtland, Gotland, Estland and Skåne becomes Swedish if they aren't already Swedish, and they can be bought. And as you may recall, Gotland was in German hands, but apparently since we've signed a peace treaty with the Danish, the Germans have to surrender that to us for some reason. And they reconquered it for some reason. Okay, I guess that's how it works, because they had a stack of army there and Sweden didn't, or something. Actually, I don't know, because we should own that province too. But apparently, since it's not Danish, I guess it doesn't happen. Would have been funny if it did, though. Our relationship to... our relationship to Denmark has been improved, which is good. Now, before I forget, relations. I wish to improve our relations. I can't improve them to better than that. Right. I can't improve Denmark either. Right. Well, I'm just gonna have to keep it this way. I'm trying to improve the relationship between us and the Germans. Right. Infantry upgrades. There we go. That should actually be it for my turn, since I'm kind of lacking in iron at the moment. Really, really, really need to start making myself some... I could actually put down some more of these hovels. Housings, whatever. That could make myself a bit more army support makings. Which could be nice. I would love to conquer a province that had some iron on it, though. Well, I can't really do that. I'm gonna put down... yeah, let's just put down three here. 170. I can't even fill that with the amount of iron I'm getting every turn, so that should be good enough. Next turn. Still at war with the Germans. Always with the Germans. Right, how are we looking? You guys... are going over here. That's an easy victory. That's tricky. I'm gonna want some more troops over there. That's an easy victory though, so that leaves this. Where they're sending all their freaking cannons. Every single one of their cannons. Right. Infantry, which now costs 20 iron. I guess it's worth it.
Good.
15,000. Welcome to the Swedish army. We're invading Germany. Actually, we've invaded Germany, so all you have to do is die to defend it. I hope you like fighting, because that's what you signed up for. The Sture family continues to throw their troops away on things they don't need to be throwing them away on. Just looking over Poland and Russia, seeing what kinds of troops they have. Russia has a ton of troops. Holy Jesus. If I can make peace with Germany, I could so easily go and take Poland. I want to om nom nom Poland. Can you tell? Oh yeah. Good and upgraded infantry. Hopefully, they'll actually be kind of useful from now on. Not that I'm holding my breath or anything, but, you know, wishful thinking, sometimes it actually comes true. It's always a possibility. And now that artillery is starting to be more of a factor, it's always good to have a bit of infantry in every army just so that you have something that's inexpensive that can soak up the bullets from it. Cannonballs, whatever. They're oversized bullets, and you know it. Oh, they can't even kill a not upgraded cavalry. Yeah, not really too thrilled about using infantry, but you don't go to war with the army you want, you go to war with the army you can afford. Die, please. And you. You know, at some point, it would be nice if they just decided to stop invading me. It's not really going that great for them. They should realize this and just move on. If you really want some land, Germany, you can invade Poland. I don't need it, I just want it. If you were to invade them, I'd be cool with that. I could actually spend some of my money and iron on important stuff, like upgrading my infrastructure. I double-clicked that guy, didn't I? Thanks, game. Not that it's gonna matter, it's just gonna take another turn, and I'm gonna be upset because it's taking another turn. Sigh. How much infantry is left there? 500. That's nothing. That killed most of them. I should have targeted the infantry in this stage. I admit it. Right there, I should have targeted the infantry. I did something stupid, and I paid for it with losing some troops. Oh, this is the big one. I still outnumber them quite handily, it's just their artillery is so massive. I'm not fond of massive artillery on the enemy's side. I wouldn't mind having massive amounts of artillery on my side. Right now it's on the enemy's side. I outnumber you 3-1. How does your army even have the morale? How do you keep your troops going into battle to face my army only to be beaten back and horribly and brutally murdered? I didn't even click him! You saw that, YouTube. I clicked the arrow. The game just decided that I was taking too long. Ugh. Well, gee, thanks, game. Now I've lost the ability to move him for one turn. Not that it's gonna matter, I was just gonna do this anyway, but still, it's the principle of the matter. I kinda want to have full control of my own army. If you don't have full control of your own army, then what good is it? Ah, more artillery fire. There are 12 cavalrymen left. 12. I beat them down from, I think, was something over 1,000 to 12. And they're not running. And there are almost 3,000 cavalry. No, wait, those are my cavalry. Oh! Okay, I thought those were their infantry for a second. And I was like, what the hell? But no, I was looking at my own numbers. Numbers get that can do that! Oh, this is just glorious. You should have moved forward last turn, but you're gonna have to do it now instead. Their cavalry is going to get a hit on in on us if they so choose to. Which might hurt a little bit. Or they could just do that. And pretty much hand the battle over to me without me having to take another barrage of their artillery. Which I'm very thankful for. Well done, game. I actually like you a little bit better now. Now then, more infantry and cavalry. It's not really like I have to spend too much time on the formations. All I need to do is make sure the enemy can't cross over to my side of the map. That. Boom. Infantry, go! Another thing about the artillery, it does seem that it, to me at least, it seems like it doesn't really matter whether you're aiming for infantry or cavalry. It's always a pretty random number from what I can tell that get killed. So, aiming for the cavalry, which are the more expensive and more awesome and strong units, sort of makes sense to me, taking them out when you're going to hit and kill just as many infantry anyway, and they are not as much of a threat. But again, I don't know all of the ins and outs of this game, as I've proven already, so I could be wrong about that, but that's what it seems like to me, and that's why I'm using them the way I do. Come on, cannon. 300, no. Okay. That needs to die. Thank you. Now we can just focus on whatever we like, which could be, say, these guys. Actually, I should have taken the guys in the back. Please kill them. No, goddammit. I got my... yeah. I deserve that. I deserve that, and I'm going to be shot in the face by cannon fire. Oh wait, maybe I'm not. That's probably for next turn for them. Yeah, they have to wait an additional turn. Excellent. There we go. Whew. The sacking of Prague. I see. In 1648, the Swedish army under General Christoph von Königsmark managed to seize the royal capital of Prague from the Germans and occupy the half of the city that lies west of the river Moldau, where an orgy of plunder lasts for 2 days. I really like how they've made that, how they put that, an orgy of plunder. According according to some calculations from that era, the loot was worth roughly 7 million riksdaler. Which... Right. Yeah, it would be several billions of Swedish crowns by today's standards. It's a huge amount of money. Right. As a comparison, Sweden during this time demanded only $5 million in like a retributional thing for the entire 30-year war. Casualties, pillages, lootings, everything across 30 years was worth $5 million, and they looted 7. That's pretty awesome. Königsmark loads up 5 wagons for himself, filled with gold and silver, and among the spoils of this little endeavor is the Silver Bible, whatever that is, which can be viewed in Uppsala University Library, and the Devil's Bible, whatever that is, which is currently in the Royal Library, and an old lion. The lion is transported to Stockholm and allowed to live next to the Stockholm Castle. I, however, receive 2,500 silver from this for doing nothing, just reading a bunch of text and translating it for the YouTubes, of course. I see, so this is probably the part where we make peace with Germany, I hope. I really hope. After 1619, God, we Swedish and our numbers. 1640. No one is particularly interested in continuing the 30-year war, but it's not always that easy to end a war. It kind of goes on its own volition, even though no one really gains anything from continued fighting, just like we're doing down in Germany. The Germans aren't gaining anything from fighting me, and I'm not gaining anything from them fighting me, and I'm trying to make peace. In 1640, I got it right that time, delegations start amassing in Munich and Osnabrück. I don't think I pronounced that correctly, but whatever, that's the best I can do. In Westphalen, to arrange for negotiations for peace. But the coming 7 years, most people just argue. Yeah, just basic argumentation about what and who and where. Münster och Osnabrück has, during this time, a population of 10,000, and 150 delegations are gathered there. The Congress grows to... the Congress in this part grows into its own little industry with jesters, prostitutes, and painters. And the population of the cities more or less doubles. on October 14th, 1648, the peace treaty is signed, which is called the Westphalian Peace. The entire ceremony takes over 8 hours, and Sweden is given Vorpommern and parts of Hinterpommern, Wismar and Bremen. Wismar remains formally Swedish up until 1903. Interesting. And another person who gives renown points when he dies. David Klöcker Ernstral. Ha. Huh. Friends with Erik Dahlberg from youth. His talent as a painter is discovered by Carl Gustav Wrangel. He is made a painter of the court and supported by the widowed Queen Maria Eleonora, who pays for a long study trip to Germany, England, France, and Italy for this guy. Inspired mostly by the Italian Baroque, he paints many famous writers' portraits, among others of Carl XI and his horses. He paints portraits of most of the Caroline. Yeah. Tongue, work with me here. I'm trying to record for YouTube and I can't do that if you're not going to form the words that I'm trying to speak. He makes portraits of most of the influential people during the Carolingian era, which is that Swedish era thing. Okay, so this is a guy who lets us upgrade stuff. Erik Dahlberg. Who started out being named Jönsson. And he's the son of a bookbinder. But he ends up as Count and Marshal somehow. Interesting. Okay, so his career is mostly being good at constructing fortresses, some of which are still remain to this day. The towers, the Lion and the Crown in Gothenburg, and Dalare Skans outside of Stockholm. Okay, so he marched under Carl the 10th of Gustav at the March over Belt, and also participates in Carl the 11th's war against the Danish. He's also given the title of Governor General of Livland, which I don't really remember where it is off the top of my head right now. He made plans. He basically made the plans for the towns of Karlskrona and Karlshamn. He made a few other famous buildings, or at least famous in Swedish standards. The plans for all of his buildings are given out in a book called Suecia Antiqua et Moderna, something. Which is an invaluable source as to how many of the Swedish castles looked during the 17th century. Apparently, he also made the blueprints for his own grave in Turinge Church in Södermanland. Right. Agneta Horn. Another one who gives us renown points and a bit of silver when she dies. The oldest daughter of Gustav Horn of Bjarneborg. She wants to marry out of love, which is considered highly inappropriate. And she refuses to marry. She refused to marry the husband her family had picked out for her. Eventually, she gets what she wanted and marries the guy she wanted, which is described in her autobiography, Agneta Horns Leverne. Right, one of the better books, so to speak, in ancient Swedish memoir literature. Among other things, it describes family life among the nobility during this time period. Apparently she is buried under the floor of Björklinge Church, some wherever that is, along with her husband Lars Kruse, a colonel in the Västgöta regiment who died in Poland with the Swedish troops who were there. Once every 10 years, her tomb is opened and people are allowed inside to look at the beautiful 17th century coffins down there. I see. Are we at peace with the Germans? I would like it if we were. Personalities. People have died. Does it say if one of them, Brandenburg, that should be down there. Development, we built some stuff. Renown points are looking even more ridiculous now that everyone has 10 million renown. History, right, I gained the money. Our relationship to the Germans have been improved even further. Not just because of what I did. Okay. So we have a 10-year peace. I'm going to spend a bit of this silver here to try and improve that. There we go. There we go. As good of a relationship as we have with the Danish. Now, I'm not going to go straight into war with someone else, mostly because I need to kind of look over my territories, make sure I can upgrade the stuff I want to upgrade. Like that. Increase my iron supplies, and I don't feel the need to really give myself any more troop support capabilities. I can't look at those other territories because I don't own them. Right. Right, 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 right. Oh, what the hell am I supposed to do with all this silver? Actually, okay, Gustav Horn is under my employ. Ah, I got the Ashberger guy. Excellent. Excellent, excellent, excellent. Who else do we have here? I might as well spend it on people. No more money. I don't want him. Does this guy do a 15%? Okay, he increases my tax income, not so interested. I'm trying to get rid of it. Okay. Cavalry gets plus one to attack. I can get behind that. 350 seems to be a good number. Who are you? No. Excuse me. Oh, I don't want you. Come on. Game. Oh, this is the trouble of playing old games on new computers. They work too fast. No, 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 no. Game. I'm clicking as fast as I can. Fuck it. I'm done. That's it. I'm not dealing with that anymore. Jesus. You know, I might actually want an exercise tent down here just to be able to recruit people down here. I don't have one, do I? Not there. Not over here. Nope, I don't. Good. Exercise tent. Go! I could make a village. Earn more money. Don't think so. It spends iron and I need that. Some of these places have iron. I don't think I need two villages up here anymore, do I? I don't remember if I had any iron here or not, though. Damn it. Well, if I don't, I can always demolish that and place that up here. Yeah, that's a good point. Let's tear it down. Okay, that's how we're doing it. Tear that down. Place a smithy. Place a exercise tent. Good. Goody, 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 goody. So, I guess that's it for this turn.